This video is the second part of control valve parts. In first part we see about the control valve body parts. In this we will see what are the control valve actuator parts. So let's start the video. Here you can see the different parts of actuator: diaphragm, spring, actuator stem, diaphragm case, scale plate, stem connector, yoke. These are all the different parts of pneumatic actuator. And this is the spring loaded. So we will see what are the function of all these parts. Loading pressure connection. Another part of the actuator is the loading pressure connection. Loading pressure connection is the location where pneumatic air goes medium enters the actuator body. Location of this depend on valve shall be resting position. Position in case of failure in pneumatic medium. For fail open valve, the loading pressure connection is from the top. And for fail close valve, the loading pressure connection is from the bottom side. Here you can see A is the air connection, and this is from the top because this is a fail open. When the air will fail, this valve, this actuator will be open and make the valve open. Next part is the diaphragm. Diaphragm is the moving part of the actuator, and based on the pressure supplied from loading pressure connection, it moves up and down to give guiding action, control the valve opening. Here you can see a physical diaphragm inside the diaphragm casing, which is connected with the stem and is fixed with the nut. Actuator spring guides the valve position in case of the failure of the pneumatic supply. Spring plays the role of fail-safe condition and is very critical from safety point of view. The location of spring is different for different fail-safe condition. The actuator spring is housed below loading pressure connection in case of fail open valve, and it is housed above loading pressure connection in case of fail close. Here you can see spring. This is below the diaphragm and this is a fail open, because when there will be no air, spring will push diaphragm upside and make the valve open. Next part is the actuator stem. Actuator stem is the portion of actuator which connects the actuator to the valve stem. The guiding action from diaphragm is translated to valve plug via valve stem. Here you can see the actuator stem. This is fixed with the diaphragm and with the stem coupling. Next part is yoke. Yoke is the part of actuator which connects the actuator to the bonnet of the valve body. Yoke is surrounded the actuator stem with clearance. As you can see, the part E is the yoke, and through this part we connect it with the body of the valve. There are some other parts like rain cap, eye bolt for hold the actuator in case we want to remove it, and the stem connector. So we will see all these. Rain cap is used to protect the actuator from the air because there is a hole which is left open. Because when there is no air, the air in the upside of the diaphragm, we need to remove it, because spring will create tension, but this air is also there, so it will make restriction. So there is a hole to drain that air. This is called drain cap. The diaphragm case are the parts that are used for packing diaphragm plate, consist of two parts, the upper and lower section. So in these diaphragm case we fix the diaphragm. There are two plates up and down of the diaphragm. Scale plate is based on the position of the valve between 0 and 100. This plate shows the position of valve, physical position 0 to 100%. Next part is the stem connector. This is the link between the actuator stem and the plug stem. So these are the actuator parts. I hope you like the video. If you like the video, you can subscribe the channel so you will get my video first.